Hi friends, welcome back to another YouTube video. In today's video, we're going to talk about mentorship, and I'm specifically going to share my experience in my career, how mentors have helped me. There are three significant experiences in my career that have involved mentorship. So I'm going to share those experiences and specifically talk about why it's important to build those relationships. And there's one type of mentorship that I think is overlooked so often that a lot of us don't take advantage of. So I'm going to share that as well. Before we jump into the video, I do want to say thank you so much to everybody who has been giving me feedback. As you can see, my lighting is much, much better. I have been getting a lot of comments with all of you giving me feedback. Some of you actually reached out to me on Instagram and gave me a lot of tips on how to improve my lighting. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you so much for all the input and all the feedback. I take all your feedback seriously, and I really, really want to improve my YouTube setup as well as my content. It's amazing that all of you are part of my journey. So you have seen my like horrible lighting, bad setup videos, where some of which I've recorded through webcam, my iPhone, and to now growing into this actual proper YouTube studio setup. Still, like, I'm like sitting in my home office, but I think this looks way better than it was. So thank you again for all the feedback and input. All right, with that, let's jump into the video and let's talk about mentorship and why it's important. So who is a mentor? A mentor is somebody who is more experienced than you, and they are a trusted advisor to you. So when we're talking about career mentorship, this is pretty much basically somebody, your senior, who has been through what you are going through right now and or in similar experience, and they are able to give you advice and able to give you guidance based on their experiences and based on their knowledge. So there are two types of mentor before I talk about it, because I'm going to touch on both of those two types of mentors. So one is obviously, like, if you're in a tech role, they're like technical mentors who are giving you guidance on the technical know-how standpoint. And there's like, then the second part of the mentorship is more like career development mentorship. The first one provides you guidance on how you grow technically. The second one is more of career development. Now, you can have both of them in one, or you can have separate ones. Totally depends on the scenario and depends on who you have access to. In my career, there have been multiple mentors who have influenced my career journey and helped me get to where I am today. And that includes both technical mentors as well as career mentors. Let's talk about the technical mentors that have specifically influenced my career journey. So for some of you who have watched some of my previous videos, you know that I went to a business school and then I got into data engineering. I did take a bunch of courses on my own to learn data engineering, but there was still a lot that I learned on the job. And every time when somebody's telling you that they learned on the job, it doesn't mean that they sat in front of a computer and they struggled through it and then they figured it out. Yes, that is part of it, but there is always somebody senior, a mentor, who is helping you and guiding you. For me, that was the case as well when I was starting in data engineering. The senior data engineer on the team was my mentor, and I owe it a lot to him, because whenever I needed advice, whenever I needed guidance, whenever I needed to figure out where to learn something, a technical thing that I was working on, I would go to him and I would ask him, like, what do you think I need to study on? What do you think I need to, like, read on? Are there any trainings that I can take? What do you suggest doing if I run into this type of technical issue? That was a person that was like highly influential on my data engineering learning path. Before I go further into the video, I do want to mention that the mentors that I'm going to mention are primarily all men. And last time I mentioned that I got a bit of hate on Twitter where some people saw my video on YouTube and then they started bashing me on Twitter. Basically, the backstory of this is tech is a male-dominated field. So in my team at that time, I only had male managers and male seniors. So that senior data engineer was definitely influential in my career, and they helped me grow as a data engineer and have been a truly an influential part of my journey. Now, there is not all, there are obviously, like, not everybody is great. Like, it's hard to find somebody like that. I definitely think that I got lucky with ending up in a team that was super supportive. Specifically having a senior teammate who was by my side and who was willing to guide me and help me. So that in the same team, I actually had experience with another data engineer who actually turned out to be a bully. So not everybody is going to help you. So you have to do the work to basically figure out who is interested in your career and who is willing to develop you, and focus your relationship efforts on that person. I assume that, like, when I was new in my career, I assumed that every senior person I will meet would be an amazing cheerleader, an amazing advisor, but that is actually not true. Not everybody is there to support you, so you have to do the right research and find that person who would be there to kind of like guide you and mentor you. The second mentorship experience that I had that was also truly influential on my career in data science, now moving on from data engineering to data science, my manager. And I know some of you who saw my videos on my career journey. So a lot of you have commented that you got lucky with having a good manager. Yes, I did get lucky having a great manager, actually. I didn't know, like, I interviewed for that team, like, I switched the team, and I interviewed that team, and I had coffee with my manager, basically trying to understand what the team does. And at that point, like, when I had coffee with him, when I had the introductory call, I kind of got the idea that he sounds like a great person, but it was only until after I joined the team that I realized that he is not only a great manager, he's also a great mentor, great advisor, and great cheerleader. So when I was learning data science, going from data engineering to data science, that manager basically was my teacher. We would use our one-on-one, the weekly one-on-ones that I would have with my manager. He would basically give me homework, give me guidance on what kind of books I need to read, give me ideas on what kind of projects I need to work. And then he was like my advocate outside of that one-on-one meeting room, where he would like put me in front of other people, where he would advocate for my work, where he would like pitch me and say that Sundas should work on this project. I think she has like good potential. So we would love to have Sundas work on this project. So he was not only a great mentor, but he was also a great sponsor. And now sponsorship is a completely different thing. And I think I should do a different video on this. One comment that I would say, like, there is a saying that women are over-mentored and under-sponsored. So I will definitely talk about sponsorship in another video and how I successfully turn my mentors into sponsors. But in this video, for the sake of keeping it short, I want to only talk about mentorship. So yeah, talking about my manager, 100% agree. I did get lucky. And obviously, like, I was working hard. Like, he could see that I would take his advice and I would action on it. So he wanted to help me more, even more. That again, like, goes back to like the mentor-mentee relationship. You're going to make sure that when you are building that relationship, first of all, you need to figure out if that person, what does that person has to offer that you actually need that will help you in your career, because you're gonna take their time, they're gonna take your time. So you wanna make sure that the advice that you're getting from them are actionable and you're gonna take action on it so you can show it to your mentor that how you are taking their advice and making progress on it. So that was my second experience. Basically, under his mentorship, I learned data science and officially transitioned from data engineering job family to the data science job family. In that team, I also had senior teammates who were data scientists, research scientists. They were obviously very supportive and I learned a lot from them, but my manager specifically stands out because he put in a lot of work into my career and he put a lot of work basically using our time to guide me. I know typically what managers do, I have heard like horror stories where managers are primarily using those one-on-ones for project updates, but the whole purpose of like those one-on-one relationships with your manager is to help you grow in your career. And project updates is great, but that's not gonna help you develop in your career. All right, so those were the two big influential mentors in my career. One helped me basically learn the data engineering. The other one helped me transition from data engineering to data science. The last mentor relationship that has helped me and has been influential on my career, it's not actually really one person. This is a type of mentorship that a lot of people don't discuss and a lot of people don't take advantage of. It's right there next to you, but you're not taking advantage of. What I'm talking about is peer mentoring. Yeah, peer mentoring is basically people who are at your level, not above your level, but they are your equivalent, people who know as much as you. They also have some knowledge that they can share with you, and you have some knowledge that you can share with them. So kind of like a peer mentoring. That's what it's called. That's why it's called peer mentoring. So that's like the third mentorship experience that has been truly, 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 truly helpful in my career. So for me, my teammates, no matter which team I have been in, I have leveraged those peer mentorship relationship. I have put in the effort to develop relationship with my peers, whether we go on a coffee chat and have a discussion about work and project, or whether we have like a weekly one-on-one or bi-weekly one-on-one set up where, or one-off one-on-one set up where I'm actually trying to learn about their work. They're trying to learn about my work. And if there's something that I'm stuck on, like I can ask them, maybe they have worked on something similar. So this is the type of mentoring that is called peer mentoring. And it's actually, all of you have access to it. So you should take advantage of it. So what I want you to do, if you haven't done peer mentoring, what I want you to do is like set up time with your teammates, set up time with your classmates. Like, those are the people, they probably know something that you don't know, but if you talk to them and if you ask them, they can probably give you some guidance. And you can do the same way. So it's like kind of like an equal relationship with where both of you are taking advantage of each other's knowledge. So yeah, that's all I wanted to say in today's video. If this content was helpful for you, make sure to give this video a thumbs up because it will help it with the YouTube's algorithm. And subscribe to my channel if you want to hear more about data science, tech lifestyle, and career journeys, and everything else in between. Let me know in the comments, what was your best mentorship experience? And have you heard of peer mentoring? Have you taken advantage of peer mentoring? And when it comes down to mentorship, what advice do you have for other people? All right, with that, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a beautiful day, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.